So you're having a destination wedding, you're wondering, how do I get my dress to my destination wedding? In this video, I'm going to give you some ideas and thoughts on that. Hi, I'm Jack with Vacation Ease, and as you know, we've been planning destination weddings for a long time. I post videos every Tuesday, so do me a favor and hit the subscribe button, and you'll get notified every Tuesday of new videos coming out. So I was recently on a plane and almost saw a fight break out over a wedding gown. So I thought I'd make this video about this. So how do you get your wedding gown to the destination? Well, let me tell you a couple things not to do. So do not ship your dress from your gown company, the bridal store, or from home to the resort. I was at a resort 2 weeks ago with the wedding coordinator, and there was a bride in tears. She had shipped her dress via UPS or DHL, I'm not sure what, I overheard part of the conversation, and the dress never made it to the resort. She had a tracking number, she couldn't follow the tracking, but do not ship your dress to a resort. It is unlike the US where everything is tracked and you can see it, even though they provide the tracking numbers, the resorts say that they just don't see the stuff. So that's the first thing I would tell you is don't ship your dress. The next thing is when I was on this plane a couple weeks ago, I saw a bride and groom get on and they had their dress. They were sitting in like row 40, all the way in the back of the plane. So the first thing they did is they got on, they went to the first class section of the plane, opened up the storage bins and attempted to lay the dress out over two bins. Well, the flight attendant was not having any of that because she said, are you seated in first class? They said no. So they went to the back of the plane. And then I heard the flight attendant have to go back there because they did the same thing in the back. And then evidently everybody in that section that wanted to use the overhead bins, the groom was telling them, you can't put your things in the overhead bins because my wedding dress is there. So again, you can't do that. The other thing is, I've seen people get on and say, can you put this on the storage closet? Well, if you've been on a plane lately, there are no storage closets in first class or in coach anymore. In the old days, 2, 3, 4 years ago, there were, but the airlines have taken all those storage closets off to put more seats on planes. So it's not as though you can just hand it to the flight attendant as you get on the plane and say, can you please hang this for me? There's very few places to hang a dress or anything, a coat anymore. They're trying to make money. So you can't lay it across and stop people from using the storage bins, but evidently that's what this groom attempted to do. So I think my first two hints, what we tell our clients to do, which is the safest way to get a wedding dress to a Caribbean, Mexico, or any destination internationally, would be this. Spend a little bit of money and book first class. It's not that much more and you deserve it. Enjoy the flight to and the flight from, you can have champagne, you'll be taken care of, but then you may have the accessibility in many of the first class sections. There is an area behind the last row in the section that things can be hung. The flight attendants may try to hang them there. They may lay your dress over everybody else's stuff in the storage bins, but you will have a much better chance of having access to a little bit more personal care on these flights, which are now full, if you're in first class. And again, it's a better experience. Maybe you'll spend a couple hundred dollars more per person, we're seeing, from wherever, to Punta Cana, to Mexico, to Jamaica, the top three destinations. My third idea on what you can do would be go out and buy a cheap suitcase, a hard side suitcase. You can buy them for $100. Just buy a cheap suitcase and just put the dress in there by itself and ship it. This way it's the only thing in there, it's hard side, you know it's not going to get crushed by the other bags on the plane, and it's going to get there because you're going to check it in and you're going to check it out, you'll have it with you. My guess is at the end of the day, you're going to pay for a suitcase, you're going to pay to ship the bag. If you don't want to bring the bag back, who cares, leave it wherever you are and just shove the dress in another suitcase if you don't want to pay the bag fee coming back, or if you don't really care about the bag, leave the bag in the destination. Just, it's an easy way to get the dress there safely in one piece. So again, these are just some tips and hints because I've seen things recently and I just want to make sure our clients and you, even if you're not a client, are able to get your dress to your destination in one piece. It actually shows up so that everything you've dreamed of you can wear your wedding dress, and you're not counting on a coordinator at a resort to find you a dress in that destination, or just really start your wedding with a really bad experience of not having a dress or having a crush dress.